everyone, Christina here. Welcome to another Color Wednesday. Before we get into this cute stamp set, I want to tell you guys about Stretch Your Stamps 2. It's our latest class at Online Card Classes. It starts in just a couple weeks on August 4th. So now is the time to get registered for class. It's going to be super, super fun. This class is all about exploring different ways to use stamps. It's going to give you some fun ideas on how to use outline stamps and alphabet stamps and graphic stamps and just all sorts of different ways that you can use different stamping techniques in your card making. So go ahead and head over to my blog over at kaywarnerdesign.com for some more details. It's in today's blog post, and I'm also giving away 3 spots in class. So be sure to head over there to enter that giveaway if you want to take Stretch Your Stamps too. So on to today's card. I'm using this stamp set from Newton's Nook. It's from their latest release, and it's got these really cute flamingos on it. So I'm stamping the flamingo that has the little inner tube around its neck. I'm stamping that in some Memento Tuxedo Black ink because I'm going to be coloring it with some Copic markers. So initially when I planned out this card, I thought I would have the flamingo just stamped directly onto some cardstock and add some color around the flamingo, but I eventually ended up cutting it out. So you'll see that it's kind of stamped off to one side, but it's not a huge deal. So I'm coloring the flamingo with 3 different colors of pink, and these colors were actually kind of hard to blend. The 2 darkest colors weren't so hard to blend, but that lightest color was very, very light compared to the medium color RV14. So I think if I was going to color this again, I might not even add that darkest color because it seemed to be okay just using the lightest and the medium. I kind of experimented a little bit. These were some new pink colors for me that I haven't used combined together, and sometimes you just have to experiment and see what works, and sometimes it just doesn't work. So basically, I put the light color down, added the medium, went back to the light, added some dark, and then added some medium, and I just kind of like went back and forth between all those colors to try to get them to blend. And it's even a little bit more noticeable as I color the rest of the flamingo's body that these colors were giving me fits. I just could not get them to blend as nicely as I had hoped. But it's not a huge deal. The flamingo is very small in comparison to the rest of the card, so I didn't feel the need to recolor him just to get it the way I wanted it. Plus, I am going to end up covering the flamingo with some Wink of Stella clear glitter shimmer, and that also helps to sort of blend those colors, even though like it looks like they're blended. But even though I know, and you guys know because you're seeing this at the beginning, that it wasn't super blended well. So I'm just going to go ahead and keep coloring over this. When you're using Copic markers, it's almost about just layering color upon color upon color until they all start to mix and meld. You can picture that that color is seeping into the paper and it's still wet. So if you add more color to it, those colors can sort of blend down in the paper. But you have to make sure that it's wet while you're doing it because you can't get it to blend if it's already dry, if that makes sense. So I'm just adding more and more color, and I really should have just stepped away from it at this point, but I just kept going. Okay, like I said before, I'm going to put some Wink of Stella over the top. So now I'm coloring the little inner tube floaty thingy, and I'm starting with the lightest yellow color. I'll just do a whole wash of that lightest color. Then I'll go in with the Y18, which is kind of a more vibrant yellow, and I'll add that as a shadow just on the one side of the inner tube. Then I'll come in with this YR23, which is a little more toned down yellow. It's kind of a muted yellow orange. And that adds a little bit more shading, and I use the Y21 to really blend out all those colors. At this point, I had to look on my iPhone for what a flamingo's beak looks like. Turns out they can be kind of yellowish to yellow-orange, depending on the type of flamingo, so I just decided to give him a little bit of yellow and then a little bit of orange and blend that out with the yellow again. And then I colored the dots on the inner tube, and I started with YG13, but then I decided I didn't really like the green, so then I colored over the top with BG05, and it gave it a little bit more of a tealish color with the green and the blue combined, and I kind of liked that color combination just a little bit better. The green was okay, but I kind of liked it to be a little more blue. So this is where my plan changed. I see that flamingo up in the top corner. That was on masking paper, but ended up to just cutting out the flamingo itself. So I cut around the flamingo and then took my Memento Tuxedo Black marker and used the brush tip to paint the edges of the cardstock. This makes it look like it's been cut out even more perfectly than I did. It was a really rough cut. So the areas on the inside that I cut with my X-Acto knife, I put the flamingo down, face down, and then just color it on the inside. That helps us so you can color those inside pieces without accidentally coloring all over your cut piece. So I have some, let's see, this is Nina 80 pound cardstock in solar white, and I'm using some antique linen distress ink, and I'm just bringing in that color at the very bottom. I'm creating the background for the flamingo to be on top of, and I wanted it to sort of look like sand, and then it kind of fade to a white, and then fade into a blue to create the sky. So I started with antique linen and just brought that in, but I noticed it was looking just a little bit too kind of greenish almost. So then I brought in some brush corduroy just to tone that down by adding a little bit of brown. And it wasn't the perfect sand color, but it'll do for this. For the sky or the sea, the ocean, whatever you want it to be, I'm using some tumbled glass. And I'm just really lightly bringing that blue color all the way down until it almost meets the sand. I just wanted that kind of hint of a background. So after I had that, I needed to stamp my flamingo. So I took a post-it and just covered up the flamingo part. I'm just going to add ink to his legs. And I'm using Memento Tuxedo Black ink once again, just so all that the blacks match. And I'll take off that post-it and clean up with my fingertip just a little bit that got onto the flamingo's body. And then stamp that down onto my background piece. I like that you can see the entire stamp. But it's only stamping the legs because it gives me a really good idea of where that flamingo is going to be. So I put the sentiment Happy Bird Day and then some birds. And you'll notice there's some little blips in that top left corner where I only wanted one bird, but it kind of stands a little bit of the other two. I'll go back in and add that with a marker later. The card base is made out of some 100 pound Solarite cardstock from Nina, and I'm just going to place that right on top with some foam adhesive. It's bigger than the piece that I used the distress ink on, but I'm going to kind of center it up there on the top, and I think it kind of looks a little bit like a Polaroid picture where it's got all that white at the bottom. I just think it looks really cool. In order to adhere the flamingo, I'm adding some Cool Tack clear adhesive, just putting that behind his head and his beak and on his body. And then I'll go ahead and place that on top of the legs. So it's adhered on there quite nicely. And now I'm going to zoom in and start adding some detail. So I'm adding the clear Wink of Stella brush pen. It adds a really nice subtle shimmer. You really have to see it up close on camera in order to see what I'm doing here. You'll see in a minute all the shimmer. And in real life, it's really, really pretty. And I think that the thing I like about the clear Wink of Stella is it doesn't really change the color underneath it. So now I'm bringing in some glossy accents, some Ranger glossy accents, and I'm adding that glossy accents to the flamingo's beak and then also to that floaty inner tube thingy around his neck. He looks like he's going for a fun day at the beach or at the pool, either one. So I'm just coating that with my glossy accents, making sure I get all those areas. And then I'm going to show you exactly all that shimmer. I think it's so, so pretty. And the glossy accents looks a little bit cloudy right now, but it will dry to be completely clear. I think that's so pretty. So that's generally the card. I felt like that there was a little bit of emptiness right at the bottom, so I added a little bit of a dashed line. And that finishes the card for today. I hope you guys enjoyed. Don't forget to go over to my blog for that giveaway for stretcher stamps too. And just a reminder that all of the supplies are listed at the blog post for today, or you can see all the supplies for today's card in the video description below. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you guys next time. Thanks for watching till the very end of the video, you guys. The three videos on screen are the three most recent videos on this YouTube channel. The first one was a Q&A I did with Jennifer McGuire last week. I've also got some faux calligraphy right there in the middle, and then a really fun one-layer birthday card over on the right. So I hope you'll check those out. And once again, you can visit my blog at kaywernerdesign.com. You can hit that subscribe button in the top corner, and you can catch me on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and Pinterest. I appreciate you guys so much. Thank you for subscribing and watching my videos every week, and I will catch you guys on Friday for a new Friday Focus video.